Hello, lovely people. I welcome you once again to Bright and Clara's channel. Thank you for clicking. I wish you all a Merry Christmas and a prosperous New Year. This is episode 3 of the 4-bedroom house that we are putting up for Madam Kate, my subscriber, and this project is located at Winneba. Okay, in case you have a project at Winneba, Elimina, Takrade, Kumasi, Wale Wale, wherever you are, we are coming. The estimated cost for this project is 168,975 Ghana cedis, 5 pesos. Translating into dollars is $19,871.51. The purpose of this figure, as you see, is that she had already purchased sand, stone, cement, and iron rods. So if we are to add those purchases to this estimate, as I've made mention, it will still not be that high, probably around $22,000. So if we add miscellaneous, I would say $25,000 for this beautiful house. This is without plastering and the finishing, just the block work all the way to the roofing. You will have all your roofing and it will cost you around $25,000. It's a 3-bedroom plus an outhouse, making it a 4-bedroom. In your view is my steel bender, Isaac Gomado, and his boss. That's the boss in the black shirt, okay? And Isaac is the one taking the shot. Isn't that beautiful? They work together as a team. Yeah, so they went to Winneba to do the steel works for Madam Kate. And here, this is the mat. This is what we call the mat, okay? Yeah, so we are using 12mm high tensile. 12mm high tensile. There are two types of iron rods. The 12mm standard, which is the local one, and the 12mm high tensile, which is the foreign one, okay? So in case you're buying an iron rod, she bought this ahead of time. So if it was left to me, we would have used 14mm. This is not a story building. This is just a ground floor building. So we don't need that expensive iron rod, but we need something reasonable and stronger. So I was lucky, she was lucky, she bought the 12mm high tensile. If it was at a local one, we would have rejected it. So in episode 2, if you haven't watched episode 1 and 2, I highly recommend you go back and watch them. In episode 2, we started off with the footing block work. So this is what we call the footing block work. Okay, footings. These footings will come to a certain height, about say 5 feet, 4 feet, depending on the landscape. Okay, if you are in a hilly area, some places of the block will be shorter and some places will be higher. And that will all vary depending on the landscape. The total blocks that we estimated for the footing is 1,800. Okay, 1,800. So it is good that you have enough blocks for your project. Whether you're building a 5-bedroom house, or let's say even it's a story building, you have 2-bedroom ground floor and 3-bedroom upstairs, they're all going to be the same. You must have maybe 2,500 blocks for the start. Are you with me? If you have enough space on your plot, that's fine. You have 2,500 blocks. You have your two trips of sand, 2 trips of stones, okay? You have money ready for cement, money ready for iron rods, and that of the workmanship, man, you are good to go. Are you with me? So start preparing yourself ahead of time. Get your blocks, get your sand, get your stones. Those things you can guess ahead of time. They don't go bad. Are you with me? So Mr. Stephen Opon is my right-hand man. Stephen is a well-trained mason. Okay, he does parapet, window designs. He builds, you know, houses. You know, so Stephen is a multi-purpose person. Are you with me? Stephen has lived here with me in Dubai. And like I keep stressing, these are people that I know and I trust them. So when I give you my word, I give you my word. I am responsible for every word that I've uttered. I am responsible for every content that I'm sharing on my channel. Okay, I am responsible for everybody. All the artisans that I post on my channel, I am responsible for them, okay? And that is why I make sure that here on this platform, we are not joking. We don't joke. And we are serious and we mean business. Are you with me? So if you have been disappointed and you have been scammed and you feel like not building anymore, I am here to give you hope that you can do it. I have been through it before, and that is the main reason why I have decided to set up this channel to help all of us. So believe me and give me your project. Every dollar must count. Every penny you send home must count. You must get results for every dollar that you send home. You understand? So that by the time you get home, your structure is ready. You don't have to be there. I will do everything. You'll get your receipts, you'll get your video, whatever that you're looking for. Steven and his team are there. So these are my team that I've mobilized. I have various artisans, and I know whom I'm going to give sensitive contract to. I don't want to joke with anybody's money. Are you with me? So here, Mr. Steven Opon have started off with the 14 blog work. After episode 2 and episode 1, in episode 2, we did casting of the foundation concrete. In episode 3 here, we are starting off with the setting layout of the footing work. And here, we need to obtain a square. As you can see, there's a rope moving all the way to the far end. They need to make sure that all the block work conform to the grid line. So here should form a 90 degrees. Once it forms a 90 degrees, then they can stack up the blocks. As you can see, they've not yet installed the pillars. They'll be doing that right after all the footing block works have been raised to a certain height, not entirely, but to a certain level. Then they will stack in all the pillars. Are you with me? Steven and his team, I brought them from Kumasi. Okay, Steven is located in Kumasi, but that does not limit him. Wherever your project is, just let me know. I will bring them to the location. All we need is a 2-room because there are 8 in a number. Okay, once we get 2 room for them, all right, 4 in a room. Okay, rooms are not expensive to rent. If your project is going to be like a month or 2 months or 3 months, we can get a room for 3 months. They will stay there. So they will work morning, afternoon, evening. Once you are done with your project, like let's say if you're doing the footings, we are done. We will go. And then the next time when you have money, again, we will come. We will come and do the superstructure. And then we will go. If you want us to do it completely, we are ever ready. Are you with me? Yes. So here, as you can see, the footing is coming up nicely. Then we need to raise this to a certain level higher than that of the land and that of the main road, which I keep stressing all the time. Okay. And then from here, once the footing work is completed, the next is to install all the pillars. And after the pillars, then they have to cast the footing pillar concrete. Okay. The footing pillars or the columns. All right. You don't need to buy Wawa board anymore. Remember that during the profiling in episode 1, we used the Wawa board for the profiling. So we cannot remove the Wawa board until all the setting layouts are done. Because based on the setting layout, those Wawa board, as you can see, help them to be able to get the grid line completely. Are you with me? So once the setting layout is complete, then we can remove those Wawa board, as you can see on the other side. We are going to cut them into pieces for the footing pillars. Okay, so don't let your contractor tell you he needs extra money for boards. No, they are going to extort money from you, so just be vigilant. Okay, now we are using 1,800 blocks, assuming it's 2,000 blocks. The estimated cement bags will be 40 bags of cement. Okay, you need 40 bags of cement. As I taught you before, 2 bags will constitute, or 2 bags will lay 100 blocks, okay? Or 100 blocks constitute to 2 bags of cement, Okay, so you can do the probabilities. If or else, if two bars constitute 100 blocks, then 2,000 blocks will be how many bags of cement? That is 2,000 blocks multiplied by 2 bags of cement divided by 100 blocks. Okay, that will give you the number of cement bags that they need. Some masons are now charging 150 Ghana cedis for the masons. Laborers are charging 120. Things have changed now. Earlier on, a mason was taking 120 and a laborer was taking 100. Some places a mason takes 100 and laborers takes 90. It depends on the area, it depends on the mason's capability and experience and other qualities that he brings on board. So when a mason gives you an estimate, bear it in mind the competencies of the mason, okay, the experience and what other qualities he's going to bring on board. That is why they are charging. Some master masons will charge 200 Ghana cedis, okay, per day. So it means that when they come to the site, a mason and a laborer are supposed to do 2 bags of cement a day. Understand? But you can push them to do 3 bags. You know, if he's charging 150 for the mason and 120 for the laborer, I will definitely push them. I will push them to say, oh, mumfa 1 bag back on kaho. I will always push them. But it is good when you give it out in a contract like I'm doing now. I will prepare the estimate for you. And then once you approve it, my team will go to the site and start working. If you are located in a rural, you get us a 2 rooms. My team will come, stay in there and work for you. Are you with me? Rest assured that every dollar must count. Every dollar must count. You are working so hard and you send money home and people are eating your money left, right, left, right. Believe you me, I am here to help you. That is my goal. That all those real estate that you see, $200,000, $500,000, $250,000, just for a 3-bedroom, 4-bedroom house, I will use $35,000 or even up to $40,000 for a story building, 5-bedroom, 4-bedroom. Okay? Yes, once I prepare the estimate, you take a look at it. Based on the size, the capacity of your building will determine the cost. You understand? And the finishing also will be determined by your taste. Are you with me? So all these we're going to factor. And you can see that you will build your house without even reaching $100,000. Without reaching $100,000. Are you with me? So budget yourself. Prepare your money. Call me. Let me give you an estimate as a reasonable cost. And let's see what happens. You see, I will build your house and you will clap for me. And you will even dash me something. All right? So for me, I am ever ready. What gives me joy is to prove you beyond reasonable doubt. Okay, that's what gives me joy, is to prove beyond reasonable doubt that $25,000 can put up a 3-bedroom house neatly. $30,000 can put up a story building. $35,000 can put up a story building, which is a 5-bedroom or a 5-bedroom single story. You understand? We'll lay up the entire structure for you and then we'll continue with plastering and all of that, which will come in a different estimate. Are you with me? So rest assured that we are here, we don't do scamming. I am responsible for each and every person. I keep saying that. I am responsible for every artisan that I place on my channel. I'm responsible for my words, everything that I say, every artisan that I post on my channel. I am entirely responsible for them. And I make sure that all the people that I put on the channel reflect my vision and are ready to do the work. Are you with me? So, lovely viewers, kindly share this to your friend and your friend and your friend and your friend. Subscribe if you haven't, okay? Yes, what are you waiting for? Now, you can see that the footing work is coming up nicely. So from here, you can see that Mr. Stephen Oppong has started stacking in some of the pillars. You know, he's fixing some of the pillars. So in the next episode, which I'm going to be showing pretty soon, you will see that the footing pillars, the carpenters need to come and take off these boards, as you can see at the peripheral. They will take the board because now we don't need the boards anymore. They will cut the board and then they will board all those pillars, and then we have to cast the footing pillars. Are you with me? So, Madam Kate, thank you so much for yet another opportunity that you've given us. We truly appreciate it, okay? And I will make sure that your project is successful, okay? And you can smile. By the time you get home, your house is completed, cozy, beautiful, okay? All right, so from here, I want to say again, thank you to Madam Kate. She provided, again, the accommodation. She paid for their transportation from Kumasi to come. Okay, she gave them food. I mean, what kind of a superhuman is this? You know, when you consider the human factor first, before all other things, you get everything smoothly. And the blessing that comes thereafter. So, Madam Kate, God bless you. May the Almighty God protect you and guide you and give you more money whilst we successfully execute your project, okay? And that is my goal. So Stephen is an honest guy, very faithful, and he doesn't disappoint. He's a straightforward guy. He doesn't joke at all. So don't mess with him, because he's a straightforward guy. He will tell you his peace of mind. So be ready. Once you're ready, contact me, and we are ready to work. We are not joking. We are ready to work. And some clients are very stubborn, but we will manage them. We will manage them. Okay. So in the next episode, I'm going to be coming your way with the boarding, where my carpenter Joshua Adam will come and board all the pillars. Once that is done, then we have to do the painting with the bitumen, and then lightride filling, and then compacting, and then the other rest plumbing will come. All right, so lovely people, thank you for watching. Thank you once again for all the support and the love. I wish you all a Merry Christmas. In case you want to reach out to me, it's brightantonio@outlook.com. From me to you, it's shalom. God bless you wherever you are. Bye-bye.